The title of the paper I will discuss today is Natural History of Airway Hyperresponsiveness and its Association with Asthma Traits. So airway hyperresponsiveness, from now on we'll call it AHR for short, is a cardinal feature of asthma. Guidelines suggest using AHR when asthma diagnosis remains in doubt. However, not all asthmatics have AHR and not all with AHR have asthma. And the relationship or overlap between these two conditions might change over time. We studied the natural history of AHR in relation to asthma, atopy, and lung function using methacholine bronchial provocation testing in the Isle of Wight cohort in 783 participants at 10 years, 585 at 18 years, and a small subset of 86 at 26 years. During adolescence, AHR prevalence goes down as it improves in the vast majority, that is 81% of children. At the same time, interestingly, asthma and atopy goes up from 28% to nearly 40% for atopy, and asthma increased from 15% to 18%. So this discordance during adolescence changes the dynamic of AHR and asthma and how we use AHR for asthma diagnosis. While AHR was high at the age of 10 years, that is 21%, nearly 40% of these children did not have asthma or wheeze. At the age of 18 and 26, however, the prevalence was low, only 5%, but nearly all those who had AHR did have asthma. Therefore, we need to use AHR differently during childhood and during adulthood. In childhood, it's a good tool to rule in asthma because of its high sensitivity. While at the age of 18 and 26, that is in young adults, it has a high specificity, and thus not having AHR is a good test to rule out the possibility of asthma. Thank you for your interest in this topic.